like how to switch between windows. If you have multiple windows, how to switch between the windows. That means consider some clicks causing new windows. Okay, at that time, if you want to perform some operations on your window, first we need to switch to new window, and then we should perform the operations on that window. Okay, so how to switch the control from one window to another window, we'll see. And one more, switching between frames. Okay, consider web page can contain multiple tags, right? See, one second. This is one web page, you can see. If you right click and inspect, you can see or you can view the source code of this web page. Okay, all these are different tags. See, one is head tag, body tag, inside that div tag and div tag, okay, closing body tag, HTML tag. Like that, we have something called frame tag. Frame is used for dividing your web page into different portions. Okay. Now, that what is the functionality? If you don't also, okay, fine. Okay, that doesn't matter for us how it will work and all. But there should be a tag whose name is frame. Okay, frame tag is available. If your web elements are available inside frame, okay, directly you cannot perform operations on it. First, we need to switch to that frame, and then only we should perform operations on it. Okay, those things we will see, and then we'll move to page object model today. Okay.
Venkat, one quick question. So, are we going to cover interfaces as well?
Interfaces. Okay. At the end of this session, right? Here we will use some interfaces. I thought of covering it in Java only, but if I try to explain at the time, you may not understand clearly. So I thought after covering some of the Selenium concepts, I will explain.
Okay. Thank you.
Interfaces. It is like same as class only. Inside class, what we will write generally? Some methods we will write, variables and methods, right? Like that, in interface also, we can write some methods, but we don't provide body for the method. Then we may get doubt like, if you don't provide body to that method, what is the use of writing that method? That is just a declaration, okay? There is a way some other class can implement that interface, okay? That we will see later, okay? I will cover it.
Thank you.
Did you guys practice sending Gmail, that Gmail program?
Yes.
So no doubts in that, right?
Yeah, no doubts. Yeah.
Okay, that program only I will take, and then I will try to convert it into page object model, okay? Before going to that, let me finish switching between windows and switching to frames, okay? See, one example is Citibank. Let me open Citibank site. See, this is the page, right? If you want to log in, we should click on this login now, okay? If you click on login now, see, it opened new window. See, are you able to see in below? Two windows it is showing. Okay, one window. This is one window. Another window where login credit. This is login window. Okay, here we need to enter. Suppose if you want to enter through script, if you want to enter data inside this field. Okay, if you want to enter data inside this field, what you are supposed to do is first, after click on this login now, okay, it will open new window. You must switch to the new window, then only you can enter data into that. I will write a program and then we'll see. Okay, this is the URL. Okay, now let me on this. Guys, in my sessions, I will use Chrome browser because in Chrome browser, finding XPath and all bit easy. Developer tools, plugins are by default we get in Chrome browser. So we use Chrome browser only for our programming or for these sessions, okay? Is weight mechanism implicit and explicit? Is it clear or any doubt in that, guys? Hello?
I thought yesterday Anil left us somewhere and he said you will start the today's session with that.
Okay, then fine. Okay, after this I will cover that also. Okay?
Okay, okay.
I'm going to create a new project. So I'm writing a class. This class is to demonstrate switching between Windows. Okay. So I'm going to give the name Windows Switch. Okay. Windows Switching or Windows Switch. I'm making this method as main method. Sorry, I'm adding a main method also to run my program. Main is required. Okay. Now, first of all, tell me guys, how to create, how to launch the browser? How to launch the browser? Please respond.
Use a Chrome driver, exe, call it.
Exactly. There is a class, Chrome driver, right? Chrome driver. So Chrome driver, driver equal to new Chrome driver. Okay, no Chrome driver. Now, whenever we run this statement, automatically it will launch the browser, right? Whenever you create object for Chrome driver, it will launch Chrome browser. If you create object for Firefox driver, it will launch Firefox browser. Internet Explorer driver, if you create object, it will launch Internet Explorer browser. Based on your interest, you can launch any one of these browsers. Okay, now, see here. First of all, before using any class, okay, here we are trying to create an object for that class. But is this class available inside my project? Just now I created a project, Selena. Inside this, is this class Chrome driver available? No, right? So if you want to use a class which is available in some other project, first you need to import it, then only you should use in the sense create object, and using that object you call your interested methods. First of all, if it is there in some other package of my project, I can import and create. But is this class available in some other package of my project? No, this class is available in Selenium jar. Okay, so we should link it. Right, then only we will get that. See here, now line number 7 is showing error. Okay, if you keep the cursor there, how many quick fixes is it showing? 5 quick fixes are available, like that it is showing. It is not showing import statement suggestion here, right? Why? Because we did not add Selenium jar to this project build path. Okay, if you want to use any classes which are available in some jar, okay, first you should link that jar to your project, then only in your you can see those classes inside your project, okay? Without linking that jar, you cannot access the classes available inside that jar. Now, how to link it? Guys, tell me how to link it. How to add Selenium jar to your project? Build path, right? Right click on your project. Right click on your project. Build path. Configure build path. Okay. In libraries option, we have add external jars. Okay. Add external jars. In my system, okay, on desktop, I have a folder Selenium. Inside that, I have that jar file. Okay. Selenium standalone jar 3.4.0. Okay. I'm adding it. Okay. See here. Now, under libraries, it is showing that jar. Okay. Apply. Okay. Okay. Now keep the cursor there. How many quick fixes it is showing? Earlier it was showing 6. Now it is showing 7. First one is import. Okay, earlier it was not showing import state suggestion. Why? Because we did not add this Selenium jar which contains this class into our class path. Okay, our build path. That is the reason it was not showing earlier. Now we added, so it identified there is a class exists in some so-and-so package. Okay, so please import that. It is showing now. Okay, just click on it so that it will import. Okay, now let me run it. See here, in console, you can see local connections are allowed like this. Don't be panicked by seeing this, though it is showing in red color, it is not an error, okay? See, it launched the browser. Now, if you want to open any URL, okay? How to open, which method we supposed to use? We have a method, get. Get method is available, okay? Use driver.get, okay? So if you use get method will take a string argument, okay, whatever the string you will pass, that URL it will open, okay, whatever the URL you will pass, it will be entered in address bar of the browser and it will launch that, okay. Now, our intention is we want to open Citibank site, okay, so just let me try it. Guys, are you able to follow?
Yes, Venkat.
Yes, Venkat.
Any doubts, please ask me. Okay, like interfaces and all, if you have any doubts, please ask me. Okay. If it is there in today's plan, I will cover today only. If not there, I will tell you like next week we'll cover. Okay, but it is there in the plan. Okay. See, it launched Citibank. Now, what is our aim? Our aim is to click on this login, right? Now click on. Now the question is how to identify this element. There are 8 ways to locate an element or to identify an element. Okay, whatever you are seeing on GUI, all these options are everything, whatever you are seeing on this web page, this we call it as web elements, okay. See here, this city is one web element, this home is one web element, banking is one web element, credit cards is one web element, like this, all these options are nothing but some web element. For all these back end, if you right click and click on inspect, you can see the source code which is actually responsible for displaying that element, okay. See, for that banking, who is responsible? This A tag is responsible. This A tag is responsible for displaying this banking web element on UI. Okay. Now, similarly, for this login now also, some element will be there. Okay. Right click on it and click on inspect. Okay. Now, see here, there is a tag, image tag, okay, image tag available, whose title is login now, or whose SRC is this, okay, with some. See, our goal is now to identify this web element, that means this image tag, because see, generally whenever if I ask you to, guys, please go and click on this web page. Next question, what you will ask? There are so many web elements on this page, which web element I supposed to click, right? You will question me, next question, okay? Which web element I supposed to click? Then I will say, click on login now web element. Then you will click on it, okay? So similarly, even Selenium WebDriver wants to perform click operation on some web element, you should specify what is that web element, okay? Now there are so many techniques. Anil already covered those 8 techniques based on tag name, based on ID, based on name, class, right? CSS and export. You can use any of these 8 techniques, okay, to identify element. Once if you are able to identify the element, then perform operation on that web element. That operation can be either click or sending data or something, XYZ, whatever operation, like reading data from that web element, okay? We'll see all those one by one. Okay, now how to find, guys, is XPath clear? Hello?
Yes, Venkat.
XPath clear, right? Yeah. Now, all of you, please open your systems if you aren't able to do. Okay, just right click on this login now. Okay, and then click on inspect and tell me the XPath. Or else just observe for this. Later I will ask for some other examples, you can try, okay? Now, to find XPath for this, see here, based on title we will find out, okay? We'll see. See here, $x, okay? $x. Tell me, guys, XPath, what is the XPath for this? How to write XPath to find image tag? Please tell, are you able to see the screen? Is it visible?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, please tell me the XPath /, right? Image tag.
Yes.
Yeah, tell me.
So log at the rate.
Yes,
so
exactly.
The square braces at the rate log
/. Image tag and then index braces, right? Index yeah. Braces at the right. We are going to find element based on attribute.
Login. Consider yeah, login name. We'll use login now.
Yeah, title we'll use. Okay. Title attribute. Whose title attribute is? Okay, login now. login. Login now. Okay, login now. Okay. This is the XPath, right? Anything wrong in this? No, right? So now what we will do is we'll try to use that XPath and then we'll try to perform click operation. Now, tell me how to find the element. Driver has a method, find element.
Find element by XPath.
Yeah.
By.
One second. Find element. Find element, okay? Find element. There are 8 ways to find the element. Based on what? XPath will use, okay? XPath. And what is the XPath? This is the value of XPath, okay? Pass this XPath as a string argument so that it will find that element and it will return that element, okay? Once if you get that element, see, what is the return type of this find element, guys? What is the return type of this find element? See here, find element. Okay, find element. What is the return type?
Web element.
Okay, it will return web element. If you are calling a method, okay, if it is returning some value, that is up to you whether to assign to a variable or ignore it. Okay, depends upon your interest. Okay, so but we are finding particularly to use that web element to perform some operation on it. So we must assign to a variable, web element variable. Okay, that is why even though if you don't write that equal to and assign statement, it was not showing any error. Now, right now, is it showing any error? No. Why? Because return type handling is not mandatory. If you want to use it later, you take it and assign it to a variable. If you don't want, just ignore it. Later, you cannot use it. Okay? So, always assign it to appropriate variable, because why are we calling that method? We need that element, it will find and return, right? We want to use it later. Web element. Okay, see web element. Again, web element is a class, right? All class types acts as data types. So web element type element it will return. So you are creating a variable, reference variable of type web element. Is that web element available inside my project? No. So you must import it before using it, right? Now, we.click. Once if it finds the element, we should perform click operation. Sorry. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes.
Now we'll run it once and we'll see. So it is launching, okay, and then it is trying to click on login now, okay, it clicked on login now, that's why new browser where login page will get that window opened, okay, got it?
Yes.
Now, see two windows are there. After that, our goal is, once if you click on login, we should able to enter data into username field. Here, username field is there, right? In second window, inspect. Now tell me the XPath of this. Let it open. Okay. Yeah, tell me the XPath to find this input. Now, are you understanding why do we need XPath? To identify the elements, okay? Now, tell me input tag, right? Input tag.
Hi.
Tell me, guys, this input tag I want to find out, okay? This input tag I want to find out.
We can use name or user ID.
Exactly, correct. Either name or ID. Okay. Input tag. Okay. At the rate whose ID equal to
user ID.
Okay. User underscore ID. I is capital D. Okay. Now, before that, we'll check once is it returning one element or more, okay? So in console, $x, okay? This checking is just to make sure how many elements it is returning with the XPath. That means in this web page, how many elements are matching with this XPath. So that if it is matching more, later for Selenium, it will be a confusion to which one to use. Always try to write, make sure your XPath should return only one element. Such kind of XPaths only you try to use in your programming so that it will go smooth. Okay? Now, one input element only it return. So we can use this XPath, right? So XPath also proper. Okay? Now, we'll try to use that. One second. This is the XPath. Okay. How to use that XPath? Always try to give meaningful names for variables. Okay. So that web element name is login. So name also you try to give login. Okay. Now, sorry. Okay. Now we are trying to find another web element. Another web element. Okay. Control X. And this is the web element. XPath of the web element. So user ID. Okay. Now you try to enter data into user ID. Which method we supposed to use? Which method we supposed
send
to
keys.
Use? Send keys. Exactly, correct. Okay, send keys. Okay, it takes character sequence. Character sequence is equal to string only. Okay, so that is also double code only. Okay, so we'll say test user. Okay, test user 123. Okay, now we'll run it and we'll see is it entering this data into user ID or not, we'll observe. Did it click? No, still not click. Just now it clicked it. Now it open and it is trying to enter. It is trying to enter user ID into this user ID field. Okay, but it is not entering. That page loaded, still it did not enter. Okay, see the console log. What is it showing? See. No such element exception. That means what is that element? You can go little right side, unable to locate an element with this XPath. Why? Because XPath we identified and we verified in console also. XPath and all, everything is proper. Still, it is showing I am unable to locate the element. Knows whenever it is unable to find that element with some XPath or CSS or tag, whatever you will mention, there are 8 ways, right, to find element. You use any one of these 8 ways and then try to find the element. If Selenium WebDriver is unable to find that element, okay, with that condition, whatever the tag name you give or whatever the XPath you will specify, with that, if it is failing to locate that element, it will throw an exception, no such element exception. Okay, what is that element? You can see here. Okay, so it is showing with this, I am unable to find the element. Okay, you have provided an XPath. Okay, this is the XPath I am unable to locate the tenant. Why? Because after click on login, still control is in first window only. See, now window 1. Second one is window 2. Two windows are available. Okay. After clicking on login, okay, we got new window. But control won't transfer automatically. We should only transfer it to second window. If you have n windows, you can transfer it to any one of those windows. Okay. That is the reason still control is in first window. That means in this window. Okay. Here only it is trying to search or find that element user ID with the text path. It did not find it. So it returned that exception. It threw that exception saying that no such element found. Okay, got it, guys? What is the problem here? Why are we getting that? Clear? Understood the problem?
Yes, now, yes, I
did. Yeah. One second. See here, what we supposed to do after click on login, okay, after click on login, what we supposed to do is we should switch to the new window, okay? We should switch to the new window. That means the second window, okay? How to switch it? How to switch it? See, here, whenever it opens window, every window is having a unique ID. Okay, one second. Every window is having a unique ID. That ID we will call it as window handler. Okay, window handler. Okay, what is window handler? It is a unique ID. Okay, unique ID. Each window is having one unique ID. That is nothing but a number, big number like this, okay, something. How it will generate, maybe random number generation or something, somehow it will generate this kind of some big number, okay? That is window handler, okay? So each window is having a unique ID. That ID we call it as window handler. Based on that window handler, there is a method switch to. There is a method switch to. For that switch to method, if you pass this window handler, then control will transfer to that window. Okay, consider you have 5 windows opened. Okay, if you want to switch from window 1 to window 5. Okay, so each window is having unique ID. Consider window 1 has unique ID 10, window 2 is having ID 20, window 3 is having 30, 4 has having 40, 5th one having 50. Now, driver dot switch to window, one method is there, switch to window. For that method, if you pass 50, that means window handler of 5th window, then control will transfer to that 5th window. Then once if it transfer, then you can perform operations, whatever you want to perform on that window, then you can perform. Otherwise, if you don't switch, control will be in first window only. It will be searching there only. It will show an error like this, unable to locate such element. Okay, got it, guys? Now, before going there, we'll try to print the window handler. Okay, see here, before click on login, okay, before click on login, just try to print the window handler of that first window, okay? First window handler, okay? Now, how to get the window handler? Driver dot, we have a method get window handle. Get window handle will give you a big number in the form of string, okay? That is window handler, okay? So get window handle method will give the window handle of that particular window where currently control is there, okay? Out of 5 windows, if you have n windows, but at a time control will be there on any one of those windows. Wherever control is there, that Windows handler, it will return. Get window handle means, okay? Now, after click on login, okay? Just you check once, is it showing different window handle or not? Because it won't show, because you are not writing the logic of switching to new window. Okay, that means after click on login also, get window handle is giving same window handle, whatever it is showing previous. That means it is there. That means control is there on the first window only. It did not transfer to second window. It opened it. Now go and see console output. See, first window handle. Okay, it is showing that. After that also, just I copy pasted. That's why after click on login also, we are trying to print window handle. What is the window handle it is showing? See, same window handle only it is showing second time also. Okay, window handle value looks like this. CD window. Hyphen some number, okay, hexadecimal numbers, okay, then it will generate random number, or how it will generate we don't know, but each one is unique one. Okay, so now after click on login also, it is showing window handler values same as earlier, whatever is there. That means control is there on the first page itself, sorry, first window itself. Okay, now we need to switch. So we need to write the logic of switch. Okay, here after click on login, we need to write logic to switch to second window. Okay, now see guys, whenever new window opens, automatically it generates a new window handle for that. Okay, whenever new window opens, automatically it generates a new window handle to identify that new window. Okay, now there is a method, get window handles. Get window handles will give all the window handlers. Okay, all window handlers. Consider right now this program opens 10 windows. Okay, consider this program opens 10 windows. So each window is having one window handle, right? There is a method, get window handles. Okay, handles means plural. It will return all the window handles. Okay, that will be like a group, a list. Okay, now see, there is a method, driver dot get window handles. It is a set. Okay, like list set is another type of one. It is a group, right? A list, a multiple. Okay, now see, understood what is the difference between get window handle and get window handlers. Okay, get window handlers. Okay, get window handlers. Okay, now let me write logic to switch to that. Okay, now it will, what is the output of this one, guys? What is the output of this? Line number 22. What is the output?
It's a string only, right?
It will be an array of strings, right?
Yeah.
Yeah,
array. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Array, list, set, all these are for group. Group purpose, right? Each one has its own limitations, like array means fixed size. If it is a list, means dynamically you can add n number, right? All are for group, to store group of things, right? So window handles, see, it will return a set of, okay, a set of, okay, that means a group of strings, see here, if you see inside that, what is there? String. What? Okay, it is a group of strings it will return. A set of strings it will return. See, we have for loop, advanced for loop. We discussed advanced for loop, right? So I am going to use that advanced for loop. Okay, I will call this method. What it will do? Tell me, guys, what it will do? It will return a set or a group of strings. Okay, so from that string, each time I will take a window handle. Okay, window handle. I will take one window handle. When you have here array name, right side of colon, if it is array or list or anything which contains group, okay, in advanced for loop, anytime whenever you are writing advanced for loop, right side of colon is a list or something or an array or set, or it can be something which contains a multiple, right, like group. From that, one by one it will take. That group is what? Strings group. Okay, lot of strings will be there. What is that each string? That is one window handle. Okay, so it is a group of strings. That's why left side I am declaring a string variable. So for that group of window handles, whatever it will return, each time one it will come and store inside this window handle variable, and it will execute this for loop for each entry one time. Okay, got it, guys? Got it? Now here we'll write driver dot switch to. Okay, driver dot switch to. There is a method, driver dot switch to window. Okay, switch to window. Okay, window driver dot switch to window. It will take string argument. That's why I'm passing window handler string argument. Okay, what happens whenever it executes this statement? What happens? Control transfer to first window, and then it will go to second window. How many windows are there? At the end, the latest opened window handle will be at the end. Okay, so at the end of the for loop, this window handle contains, okay, latest opened windows handle. So that window handle we are sending it. There is no way to get newly opened window handle separately. That's why what are we doing? We are taking all. Okay, it will be at the end. Just take it. Okay, then what happens? First window, second window, like that. How many windows are there? Latest opened. Consider now one is there, second one it will open. So first one it will switch, from first to again it will switch to second window. Okay, now at the end of this for loop, where control will be on latest last opened window. Okay, got it, guys?
Yes.
What this for loop will do? It will take the control to latest last opened window. Okay, based on window handler we will switch. That is what it is doing. Okay, got it?
Yes.
Yeah, let me run it now. It should try to enter test user 123 in user ID field, because after click on login, what are we doing? We are switching to second window, so that it should able to identify that user ID field in second window. It should not throw the exception. I am unable to locate the element like that. It should not throw the exception now, because we handled that switching. Okay?
Okay.
Just let it finish. Is opening second one. Are you able
now
to?
It is. Yes, now it is entering.
It has control transfer. Okay. Now, just so check passes. Yeah, tell me.
Venkat, one quick question, Venkat. So here it is easy because we have only two windows. So we know we need to switch it to the second window. So, but what happens if it is multiple windows, say for example, 5 windows, but I want to switch the control to 3rd window.
Exactly. Yeah, I will cover that also. Give me 5 minutes. I will finish this and I will cover that also.
Okay. Sure.
Yeah. Now, just try to print second window handle. It should not show the same one because after switching, we are in second window. Okay? Second window handler. Whatever I wrote here, second window, and this is in double quotes, it will be printed as it is. And that window handler. Okay? That window handle. Now, control will be on second window so that it should return. Okay, or it should print that second window's window handle. Okay, just we'll run once and we'll see these two are coming same or not. It should not come same, right? It should not display same because first one is window handler of first window. Second one is after switching we are printing. That means we are in second window, right? It should have a different unique ID, right? It should not be same. It should show two different values. Let it run. By that time, we'll discuss. Gopi, you are asking like, if you have multiple windows, if you want to switch between 1 to 2, 2 to 3 like that, how to do it? It is just a for loop. It will take it to last newly opened window. That is fine, right? If you want to switch to some specified window. Okay. For that, what we have to know, we must know which window you want to transfer and what is the window handle of that window. Right?
Okay.
What is the window handle of that window where you want to switch? For that, we discussed in Java, we have something called hash map. Okay. Using that, we will try now. I will show you. See here. First window handle, it is showing ending with B1E0. Second window handle, it is showing different one. Got it?
Yeah. Yes.
So each window is having a unique ID that we call it as window handle. Okay. Now, when you are in first page, okay, before that, let me do one thing. I'm going to create a hash map. Why? Because I will explain you soon. Just create a hash map. Tell me hash map, how to create a hash map? What is the difference between a list and a hash map?
I think hash map will take two values for each item.
Two values, exactly. In a hash map, each entry is having two things. One is key, another one is value, its associated value. Key value pair will be an entry inside hash map. Okay, that is the beauty of hash map that we are going to use it here. Okay, my intention is what I will do is first let me explain theoretically, then we'll go to program. See, I will declare a hash map. Okay, hash map can take two strings, right? One is for string types only, I will take two strings. Okay, my keys also strings, my values also strings. Okay, hash map hm equal to new hash map. Like this, I will create a hash map. After creating a hash map, what I will do is whenever I switch to a window, first window I will anyhow will get. Second window, some for loop will write and will switch to second window. At that time, what I will do is I will store window name and its window handle. Window name is key. Okay, window name is key. Okay, here window names. Okay, as keys and okay, window name as key and its associated window handle. okay, as value for that key. For example, window one, comma, its associated handle. What is that handle? This is the handle, right? This one I will store into hash map. This is one. Okay, now window two. What is the window handle for the second one, right? Like this, whenever I go to a window first time, what I will do immediately, I will try to store that window name and its associated window handle as a value. Okay, like that, key value pairs I will store inside my hash map. Got it? Now, how to store that? HM hash map dot add or put, some method will be there. Okay, it can be add or put. Okay, one is this. Now, second one is this. Here just a static value I am showing, but in program we'll write dynamic value. That means we'll call that method driver.getWindowHandle. It will store that. Okay. Now, like this, second one also we'll write, right? Second one also we'll write. Now, like this, whenever I go to a new window, what I will do? I will add this statement. Here always we should write dynamic one. This value, what we will get, we don't know, right? So what you will do? Driver dot get window handle. Okay. So whatever in window one, whatever the value is there, it will return that. It will assign. Okay. Like this, similarly in window two also. Now after 10 windows, you will get all the values, right? Now you are in 10th window. If you want to go to second window, at that time, what you will do? Driver dot, how to switch? Driver dot switch to window, right? Driver dot switch to window. This will take window handle as parameter, right? So how to get window 2's window handle? HM dot, okay, hash map dot get off. If you give window 2 key value, automatically it will return its value. Window 2 associated value, what is there, that it will return. Okay, for window 2 key, what is the value available inside a hash map, it will return. What is the output of this? Its output is nothing but the window handle of window 2. So you are calling switch to window method by passing window 2's window handle. Okay, so that control will transfer to window 2. Is it clear, Gopi?
Yes. So if we want to get, so if we want to move to particular one, so how should we move? Like, for example, so we have three windows. So I want to move the thing to second window. So that itself we need to stop, or how the program will end?
Pardon? Could you please repeat? I didn't understand.
Okay, so there are three windows. Okay.
Yeah, window one.
So by use, yeah, window one, two, and three. So window three, it's not any problem. So we can use the simple for loop, and so it will get me the window three, third one. So yeah, to get the window second one, I use this program, okay? So the hash map thing. So from there, how should I do? Does the switch to, it will stop over there, or again it will go to the window three?
One second. No. Let me finish this. Once if you switch to some specific window, control will be there only. Again, okay. If you want to go back or go front, okay, backward or forward, any window, okay, you must do switch operation again.
Again, okay. That's it. So now okay. I'm clear. So one time switch will work only one at a time, right? for one window.
Your doubt is like once if you switch to a window, will it go back automatically or not, right?
Yes.
Exactly. Yeah, it won't go back. It won't go automatically. Again, you should use that switch to window and that window handler of where you want to go, that you should write.
Okay.
Yeah, that I will cover it now.
Okay, thanks.
See guys, here, window handler, okay, driver, why is it started showing errors? Yeah, we started writing hash map, okay? Hash map with key string and value string, okay? And HM, okay? Our windows, window handles, hash map, okay? Window handles, hash map equals to new hash map. When we will store the window handle inside this hash map, that when we cover page object model, at that time I will explain you. Okay, for now just we are writing in a simple program. Immediately after this for loop you write, okay? See, initially it will be having here dot. Put off
window one
and its associated window handle will get using this class, right? Similar kind of statement you write
once after log in click, right?
Yes, exactly. See here, after this, right? You write window 2. Like that, whenever new window opens, you will be writing this kind of for loop to control, switch the control to there, right? After that, immediately you store that value inside that. Okay? Now, we are in window 2, right? Now we are in window 2. Now, if I want to switch back to first window, see? Now control is in first window, right? Now control is in first window. If I want to click again on this, see here, login now, this one, if I want to click again. Guys, instead of storing into a variable and then performing, here it will return the element. Directly there itself you can perform click operation, right? So what I am doing is, after switching to second window, see here, after switching to second window, okay, I am trying to perform login now. I am trying to find and click on login now. Okay. Actually where that option is available, it is available in first window. But after switching to second window, I am again trying to click on first windows button. Now what happens? It will show error like hey guy, you cannot do it because tell me. Control is in second one. So I am unable to find that element in this window. Got it?
Okay.
For that, what we have to do? Switch to First window. How to do that? See, it entered there. It started showing error. No such exception. With login. Okay. See, If once it transfers to second window, it will pass at this statement line number 13, right? So if you want to go back, it will be, once you control transfer to some window, it will be there only. If you want to go back, you use that logic of driver dot switch to now, right? Driver dot switch to. One second, it's a bit slow. Looks like it closed the eclipse. Give me a minute, let me open the eclipse workspace. We have a method called quit, and we have a method called close also. Driver dot close, drivers dot quit, some methods are available. Whatever the window is opening through this program, those things, if you want to close automatically, we must use a method either close or quit. Okay, close method is used for closing that particular window. For example, you have multiple windows open, but the control will be in one window at a time. Wherever control is available, the window itself will close. If you use close method, if you use driver dot quit, it will close all the windows. Let me open the workspace. Guys, any doubts in this switching?
No.
What about Sajanya and Savitri?
Venkat, it's good.
Yeah, I'm fine too, thank you.
Okay. Before this statement, we should add driver dot switch to. Okay. Driver dot switch to. Driver dot switch to. And then window. Driver dot switch to window and pass that first window handle so that how to get that. Using hash map, dot get off, key value you pass as argument, for that it will return appropriate window handle, and using that window handle it will switch to that window, and then it will perform that operation. Window, window, V-I-N-D, switch to window. Before going to that, let me write how many windows actually inside window handles. See here, before click on login, how many windows we have? How many windows? Only one. So right. get window handles means it will return so many windows. How many windows are there? Before click on that, how many are there? Only one. So if you print how many window handles are there, that size, it should print only one. Number of windows. How will you get number of windows? It is nothing but number of window handles you have. Driver dot window handles dot size. So how many window handles are there? It will return that. If you see now. After click on that, after clicking on login, again you try print window handle. After switching, you are switching to first window. So if you check the first window handle, it should be same as first one only because we switch to first window handle. Got it? How many windows? Right now we have three. Because first one did it. It clicked on login and it opened and it entered here and again went back to here and it clicked on login and it opened another window. Now here see first one, how many window handles is 407. At the end it has 407. Okay, after that number of windows, after switching you are checking how many windows are there. Sorry, not after switching, after login and then switching also. Size here, line number 32. Now, after switching again, you are performing operations in first window. So at that time you are trying to print, see, after switching to first window, you are trying to print window handle. Now you are in first window, that's why it should show first window's window handle only. Got it, guys? These two are. So third one, suppose at the end here, if you write how many windows this line is printing, how many windows are there, it will print, how much it will print, back to 3. Clear? Now any doubt? No. Now let me go through frames. We have something called frame. There is a tag frame. Now let me explain that related to that. Yeah. Here, I will use the method
driver dot
quit. We have a method
driver dot close.
Similarly, we have a method
quit also.
Okay, driver dot quit. If you use this method, what happens is it will close all the windows. How many it opens through this program? Through this driver object, how many windows it opens, all those windows it will close. We have another method,
driver dot close.
If you use this one, what it will do is out of n windows, always one control will be there, that particular window will not close at all. If you use driver dot quit, it will close all the windows. Now we'll see this. Just I am running it one more time, so that this time it should only close all the windows. Please observe this, guys. I will be back in a minute. Just observe here. It will close all the windows automatically. Till now what we did, once program launches, we are seeing the output, and then we are closing the manually. Now it will only close once program execution completes because we added the statement at the end. See guys, it closed all the windows, right? And it is showing at the end three windows because we opened one more window after switching back to the first window. Till now, what we did is we tried to open a URL, right? Similarly, here, once you host it in web pages or something, web pages, you have a website which already downloaded, and it is there in your system, but it is not hosted in website. Using some IP and all, if it is not hosted there, all those web pages are there inside your system only. Those pages also you can launch, okay, you can open in URL, and then you can perform operations on that. Okay, I will show that. See here, in my system, in desktop, I have a folder HTML. Okay. Inside HTML, I have something called form. Okay. I have a form. Okay. See, form.html, one file is available inside my system. If I want to open this, I can open.
Okay.
See, this is the form, simple form. I can enter data into this.
Okay. See here.
Like this. Now. Another frame example.
Okay. Frame example.
Like this, different HTML pages. I have inside my system. Now, if I want to open these and perform some operations on that, how to do? See, let me open. Frame example. I am going to write a new class, frame example. Frame demo. Okay. Here, first thing, what we supposed to do?
Chrome driver.
Driver equal to new Chrome driver.
Okay.
So we created a Chrome driver. Whenever you are creating object, the class is not there in your project. So you should import it. Okay. Driver dot get. For get method, whatever you will pass as an argument, it will open that. Now you pass this. This is the URL inside browser. Whatever is showing that you pass it as argument. So that it will open that. Now let me run it. Open the browser, and it's going to enter that URL, so that it will open that web page. Okay. Now, here I want to enter data inside these fields. I'm going to explain this frame example. So I will open that frame example file. It's fine. Now I want to enter. Guys, once it opens this field, I want to enter data into first name field. How to do? Same right click and inspect. First find the XPath. Now tell me the XPath of this. Guys, please tell me the XPath of this.
Input is our tag.
Tell me, inside the type, we can add type equal to text means, slash slash input, at the rate, type equal to text, now C1, will it give unique element? No, it won't. Because so many inputs, text are there. Those are also having type, same text. See how many inputs, text came? Three. First name, last name, user ID, all are having same. While writing, developing the code, maybe here you are not seeing the difference. Just what we do, we'll copy paste the same thing. If you use input type text, input type text, input type text, like that, user ID, last name, all these, another one, first name, these three are having same. So it will find three inputs.
Now, Now tell me.
If it is your expert,
whatever you
writing,
are
if it writing,
if it is
finding three elements
more than one element
with that expert, that means expert is correct only.
But
that is ambiguity. That leads to ambiguity. Because it will return multiple elements with the same expert.
Consider
in our office,
Venkats
are there.
If you say Venkat, what happens?
Two members will get up.
Stand up, they'll say.
If you want to call specific guy. Some differentiation you should show. So you should not use name alone, you should say team name or something else. The expert you are going to use to identify the element should be able to return your unique element. Then scripts will not fail. It will go smooth.
Otherwise, web driver will be in confusion, it will be in confusion, it may not perform correct operation.
Got it, guys?
Yes.
Now, based on placeholder attribute, I'm going with that first name. So it is returning only one, so I can use it now. driver.findElement by XPath, and this is my XPath. This is the XPath, the text path we should pass, string format, that's why we are saying using it. I am directly, you can perform operation here also without assigning to a variable. I am assigning to variable and then trying to use it. Web element is also a class we are trying to use. First we should import that class before using it. Web element. Keep the cursor there.
It will show the hint.
One second. Web element. First name. Now fn dot send keys. Now. ABC user, test user, we are trying to give. Now run it. XPath is proper, right? No issue in that. We verified it also. It launched the browser and trying to open the URL, and when it tries to enter the data, it did not enter. And it is an console, we got an exception, and it is showing an exception like no such element exception. Why? Because it is showing that the first name XPath, whatever you use, I am unable to find that element. Now, reason is, just you right click that, even though your code is proper, if you are getting this kind of error, means you should go and check once again. Generally, Before using, only first we will check once. In case sometimes we may forget. We'll think, why is it not working? Again, you go back to the code and see. This is my input tag. Go up little up. Are you able to see any frame tag?
frame tag.
Yes.
That means that your web elements are available inside a frame. Okay. If web elements are available inside a frame, first you need to switch to the frame. Then only you should perform the operations on the required web elements. Without switching, if you try to search for that first name, it won't find. Got it?
Okay.
Now, first thing. Frame. How to see, guys? Some are showing right side, some are showing downwards. This triangles. Did you observe? Header. That means. This downwards path is like HTML, like a tree structure only, right? If you convert it, let me show that. HTML tree structure. See here, generally, if you see any element, HTML is main tag. Are you guys able to see this image? HTML is main tag. Under HTML, it has two children, head and body, two tags. Under header, again title tag, meta tag, like that something is there. Under body, H1 tag, P tag, UI tag. Under P tag, A tag, LI tag. For example, whatever you are doing right click on some element, inspect element. Like this, it is input. Consider if it is LI. Okay, this LI element. It will show all those. But here, left side, to reach LI, what is the path? HTML, body, UL. Under the HTML left side, that is not required to reach this path. That is why it will show different right side direction. Downward direction means that is the element I have to pass through to reach this element. Got it? See here. to reach input, you should pass through farm. Body, but head is not required. This is another side. Some other cell run. Body and head are two cells of this HTML. HTML, you need not to traverse this input. You should traverse through body. That means this downward arrow means these are the elements required and passing through these elements to reach input tags. That's why when you are going upward direction to see if there is any frame existing or not, just keep an eye on downward elements only. See, if it is right side direction, triangle right side direction means that this element is not part of that frame. Got it? Got it, guys? So this is the path, frame path. See, to reach input, okay, frame set, under that frame, under that document, under that HTML, under that body, under that farm, under that input. This is the way. So in that path, downward direction, if you are able to see any frame, that means your web elements are available inside a frame. Inside frame, you can have another frame also. Inside that, your elements exist. At that time, If you see like this line, you may see sometimes more than one frame also in that path. At that time, what you need to do, top to frame, first try to switch to top to frame, and then try to switch to second one, try to switch to third one, like top to bottom, you try to switch to all the frames, then only try to identify or find the element. Got it? That is.
Yes.
Now, to switch to the frame element, first find the frame element, and then switch to the frame element name. Now our goal is we need to find the frame element. Once you are able to find the frame element, then we can perform switch operation. Okay. Now, driver dot frame element. Okay, first frame element X path. You need to find. How to find this frame element? Frame element. Frame is the whose name is farm. Written one or don't know. We'll see. RLC frame whose src is farm.html. Anything you can use. Just we'll try to use name only. $x frame tag. Okay, frame at the rate whose name equals farm, right?
Yeah.
How many elements? Only one frame element. No problem. Okay. Now. Driver dot driver dot will copy paste it. This is frame, right? So always try to give meaningful names. And once you are able to find that element, there is a method driver dot switch to frame. You pass web element as argument. So this is the web element frame. I will pass that. Now it should find that element. And it should enter data also. This is how we'll switch to frame. In case your element is available inside multiple frames, you have to switch one by one. This time it entered data. Did you observe this? Yes. So if web elements are available inside a frame, first you need to switch to the frame. If it is available inside multiple frames, switch one by one. Through all the frames, and then perform the operation. One second, it is loading slowly. If you go console, after right click, this is the frame. If any frames are there, it will list here. Otherwise, generally it will show top. This web element is especially available inside a frame. That's why when you go to console immediately here, instead of top, you can see some name. That is the frame name. That is the frame. Got it?
Okay. Got it?
You need not to go and see line by line upward direction of the code, input, and above that, above that, above that. Okay, just if you click on console also, see here, input.
Input,
go up. This is one way. Just now I showed. Instead of that one, after right click here and inspect element, automatically it will highlight this input. One first way is go upward direction and see is there any frame available or not. If it is available, fine. In case, if you are unable to see like this upward direction and all, just click on console at that time. Okay. See directly, it is showing some name other than top. That means this element, whatever is showing here in a highlighted input. Okay. This is available inside some frames. Here in this orange or red color it is showing, right? Some pink color. It is showing form and all, right? That means this web element, whatever is highlighted just now, that is available inside this frame. Otherwise, by default, it will show top. If no web, whatever the elements here highlighted are not available inside any frame, okay, at that time in console, by default, it will show top. If it is showing, something means, okay, it is there inside a frame. Like frame, iframe is there. I am not sure about its functionality. I feel exactly same as frame, but it might be having some more benefits also. Frame and iframe, whatever it might be, you should switch to that. If your web elements are available inside frame or iframe, it can be anything. First you should switch it to that frame or iframe. Then only you try to find the element. Otherwise you will get unable to locate the element. Clear?
Okay.
Now try to enter data into these fields. Try to enter data into these fields. Test user,
user,
last name, I will send a mail. Can you guys try to enter data inside these fields? Okay. These examples and all, I will send you a mail. You just try to enter data into this field. Try to find the expert and then enter data inside that. So you write a similar way. How we enter data into first name, similarly we can enter data into last name, user ID and password fields. Now we have something called drop down. Did Anil cover selecting values in drop-down?
No.
Now, you guys know how to enter data.
How to click elements.
And then how to read data from a element. And how to select drop-down box like this. How to select appropriate one. That we will see now.
Before that,
there is a method.
After entering,
you try to read the text and try to print. That means just to understand. You are entering here. There is a method inside thread class to wait or pass the program execution for some time.
So I am giving 5 milliseconds.
After entering, I will try to read the same.
So this sleep method will throw an exception. If any method is throwing exception, what you supposed to do? You should handle it. So add that inside try catch. This is just to wait or pass the program execution for 5 seconds. Now we enter data and we are trying to read the same data. Consider here we are only entering and reading.
Maybe if you take real time, somewhere in some field contains some data. Like this. If you want to read it, how to read it? For that purpose, I am trying to show the same one.
So driver dot find element, read that again, find that element, find that text path, and then do get operation, get text. And web elements only, all these are web elements. On web elements only we will perform operations, either entering data from the field, or if that web element is a drop down box, selecting data, like that. There is a method, clear available. What it will do, I will show that also. Clear what it will do is if it has any data, that means backspace or delete we will do, right? Functionality it will do. We will clear all the data. Before that, let me read it and print it, and then we'll clear. We are only entering data into the field from the field we are trying to read. Get text.
Why is it not coming? One second.
Okay, here one more brace is missing. That's why get text. It is not web element. It is not web element. That's why it did not. Get text. See here. Get text means whatever the value available inside that field, it will read and give it to you. So just that it will read and give you in the stream. Reading data.
Reading data.
And print that data. Guys, maybe today it's not possible to cover the phase object. One complete day is required. That means hours. So I will cover it next week. After that, immediately what are we doing? Just pass the program for 2 seconds and then clear it. Now run it. Still it did not enter the data. Why is it waiting? So much time.
1 minute, guys. Why is it taking time? We'll see once. So frame, it will switch to that frame, after that it should enter. Till here it was working sometime back, right? Let me run it one more time. We'll see. Enter test user, and then it cleared it also. Why is it not printing text? See here, it is not reading data from that field. Did you guys observe? Yes. It is not reading data from that, and the reason is it is not printing also there. Last time also it executed, but that data is not coming. Maybe if it's test field, it will come, that I will check and let you know next class.
So what is the purpose of this? Reading data. For example, you are creating Gmail user, consider Gmail user, you are creating. Or else you are logging into Gmail account, user XYZ. After login, Now, that Gmail account, user name, right? Okay. That Gmail meant we can find that is XYZ tag. If you get text, it will return that value. Okay, what we have entered, that value you will compare, user name, whatever the user name you entered for login, right? Is it displaying there, are both matching? If you login with Gopi on top, it is not showing there. That means that value it is not coming Gopi on top, right? For that purpose.
Okay. For example, take another example. So what if we can use that? We have a method called verify and assert, right?
For that only, instead of if condition you are checking, you can use that assert method. For that assert also, what is the expected result? What is the actual result? Those two you should pass. The actual result is your username which you used for login, and the expected result is the one, sorry,
actual result is the one which you are reading using. Now let me show that select one. This one I will select. Generally, maybe this tag, when get next, will have some text here like this. Click here like this. Click here, okay. Then, the tag element you will find. Another one is text area, like some tags will be there. Those tags, whatever the value will come, that also text area, for example, one tag is there. I'm not sure what is the tag name exactly. Like this, whatever the value you are entering inside the text area box, consider that is coming like this. Okay. Then it may read using get text using. Otherwise, see, input field, start input, this is end input, like that. See, A start tag, A close tag, text area start tag, text area end tag. If something is there, that will only return using get text. We'll see for the input, this first name field. Input, this first name field, okay, it is an input tag. And there is no text for that. Input start tag, some tags for some tags, end tag is not mandatory. For A tag, slash A is required. For body tag, slash body is required. There are some tags like input, close tag is option. So only start tag will be there. After that, do we have any text here? No, right? Whatever is there in between start tag, end tag, that only text, that text only it will return. Here no text, that's why it is not returning anything. That's why we are getting just an empty, just null, not null, that is just like a space, nothing. Okay? For example, let me try another one which has that kind of text, should return properly. Get text method example will see. My HTML. If you open my HTML, here click me to get form. This is also one tag. This value I want to read. See here, A tag, here to here start tag. After that, end tag. In between, click me here like this text. So what we will do is we'll try to read this text. Got it? So we'll open that file. Let me comment that. Just I'm trying to explain get test method.
Get okay. test method.
Okay. So what is that farm name?
My HTML. Okay. Inside that. How can I find this element? This time there are eight ways, right? One is based on tag name, based on name, based on class name, based on text, based on text. Another one is CSS partial link test, right? Like that, eight ways are there. Now just based on A only, we'll try to find how to find which method we supposed to use. Tell me guys.
Eight ways. Remember?
Yeah.
Find element by tag name.
Okay.
Whose tag name is A? In that file, only one tag with A is available. That's why it will return properly. No problem. Okay.
No problem.
If you are using this tag name in real time web page, so many A's will be there. If you say, give me a tag whose name is A, it will fail. Because so many A's are there, which one I supposed to give, like that it will throw error. So string element data, or element text. Now system dot out dot println, print this. What we are expecting here? What should be the expected result? Guys, tell me what should be the expected result? Get text method. Okay. Every method, what it will do, some description will be there, right? That description I am trying to show you. Regarding this text method, there is no documentation. For this method, there is no documentation. That documentation we call it as Java doc. This is not a Java method. Maybe for all selenium methods, that kind of documentation we may not get it. For example, see here, size.
size. If you keep cursor on size method, are you able to see here what size will do? Size will return the number of elements in the set. Got it?
Okay.
This kind of documentation, they don't have for Selenium methods.
There is
Java documentation for Selenium. Even for click also, it is not showing. Because all these are Selenium ones. So maybe if documentation is there, they might have written like this. Just we'll Google it once. Get text method in Selenium. Get text in Selenium. Documentation. Selenium GitHub. See web element. Pages. Maybe this might be having. See here. There is an interface web element. So like a class, we have something called interface. For time being, you consider it the same as class only. Inside that also we'll have methods. How class will write class space class name. Similarly, interface will write interface space interface name. There is an interface. Web element. Inside web element. Get text method is available inside this. Get text method gets the visible inner text of the element, including sub elements, without any leading
are trailing white spaces.
Just text it will give, but if there is no text, it won't return anything. Handling this one also I will cover in next class because drop down box will take 15 minutes to cover that.
Okay, guys, thank you so much. Next week we'll cover
Page object model. Please try to attend. That is very important. Before starting, just 15 minutes I will cover this, how to select checkboxes, radio buttons, just find element, click on, no difference there. This is draft. I want to cover it. After that I will go to page object model. Can you also show us how to drag and drop something like that?
Drag and drop. Is that possible, right?
Even we didn't try it anytime. Just try it.
If option is there, I will.
Okay. Thank you.
Bye.
Okay, guys.
Bye.